You're watching the free version of Mocha Essentials. Follow along with projects and footage with a premium download available at BorisFX.com. Well, we're really starting to make some good progress now with our shot. In the previous exercise, we patched in the left arm, so I think it's only right that we come in now and see what we can do with the right arm. So the right arm itself, we take a little look at this one. The right arm itself is a little bit tricky in the fact that it's covered most of the time by other elements. So it's going to be difficult to, you know, automate a lot of this rotoscoping, a lot of this mask creation. So we're going to have to do this ourselves, and we're going to have to do this manually. And if we're going to do that manually, what's the technique we're going to use with that? Well, yeah, we're going to reuse our background track, of course, because when we're doing rotoscoping with a moving object and a moving camera, to make it easier for ourselves, we have to cancel out one of those movements. Otherwise, we'll just end up chasing our tail a lot. So we'll start the first frame, because that's probably when we can see the shape the most, but we can't see all of the shape. That's important to note. So I'm going to come in and I'm going to make a new shape. Actually, let's delete that, and we'll come in and we'll sort out our viewer first. I'm going to turn off the color overlays, but I am going to turn on the rest of the overlays. Right, let's come back into our X-Spline tool, because we need to create this manually, and I'm going to guess where the shoulder is. And I'm trying to get some of that musculature in there as well. I'm going to guess that the arm's going to come down here and try and get me a little bit of that elbow crossover. And I don't have to be too exact over at this part either. I just need to make sure that we're not taking in the background at the bottom there. All right, so let's do what we normally do. Right click, smooth all of those points out. And we'll come in and we'll make this one look nice. And it's good doing it this way, because we can start to infer where these points should be. So once we've made those initial points, we can then sort of bring them up and see how they interact with the other points to the left and right, and sort of infer where we should be placing those. Let's just move this around a little bit more with the X. Just make sure that we've got a bit of a crossover going on there. You know, just the normal stuff now. We should be getting used to all of this. Fantastic. All right, so now we have these in place. Actually, let's move that around about there. Yeah, good. So now we have this in place. Let's give this a name. We will call this one Arm Right Mask. And we will connect this to the background track. You see our drop down menu, because we've got so many tracks now, our drop down menu is getting quite full, which is nice. And I'm going to use the stabilize viewer up in this menu now. Remember, last time we used it, it was down here. But because we've got this other viewer turned on with the view controls, then we can stabilize it up just there. All right, so now let's come in and we have a completely stabilized background, which means we're just looking at what these small micro movements are going to be. Let's turn on the transform again. And this really is, this is one of the trickiest, or some of the trickiest bits that we are going to have to do, because we've got small micro movements happening with the arm, and we've got nothing really to kind of help us through apart from having everything stabilized out. So this is going to be where we're going to be using our skills quite a lot to really make this shape work. Let's see where the next movement comes. It's around about there. Okay. And isn't this interesting? We've come, you know, probably about a second after our last keyframe, because that's where the movement is. But yet we can see very, very little of where we were back here. The only points we have to really look at are when we're doing point-to-point matching. This is the reason point-to-point matching is so important, is this is going to give us the idea of where things are going to go to. So I'm looking at these two points here and see if we can trace those. We probably can't. We're going to be at these points here, but these are the ones that we can see. So let's have a look, see where these are going or where these would go. So these now would be down here. Okay, so let's try and get these into the right place and let's see if we can match this in. So I'm thinking this is probably going to be around about here. Yeah. And let's just rotate the whole thing. So hold down W, rotate the whole thing around. And look at that, as if by magic, everything kind of slots into place. So we might need to make some minor adjustments to these points here. But that gives us a pretty good idea of where everything should be. So you can see the importance of point-to-point matching isn't just to give us, you know, a nice smooth animation. Obviously, that is a big point of it. But it's also to help us when we have nothing else to go on. So let's see how that looks. So you see, that is going to be, that's going to be absolutely fine. Now, the reason it's not matching in 100% right now is obviously because her movement that she's doing isn't completely linear. But it does mean we've got the base to work off. So we can see here, this is, yeah, pretty much in the right place already. There we go, place that there. W to rotate that around there. And that should pretty much get us into the right area. Might have to just distort this up a little bit so that we can get in there. There we go. So it's not perfect, but it's now it's a lot easier to start to establish where the point of maximum drift is going to be. So there, that's where it's drifting. Let's make sure. Get that into the right place. So this is going to be our anchor point now. Bring it into there. And then we can just do our normal stuff just to move these other areas just into exactly the right place. Holding down the control or command key as I do it. Look at that. Now that's starting to properly come together. And as something we're doing, you know, manually, this is beginning to look pretty good, pretty smooth. Because we're getting pretty close now, we can actually start to just use the little distortion techniques, like working on the whole thing, just to do most of the minor adjustments now, which means we're you know, pretty much in the right place. Go a little bit of drift there. I think this is a rotation. Yeah, there we go. Just rotate that in. And that's starting to look really pretty good. Okay, let's do the final few frames. Let's see what happens there. That moves over into that place. There we go. Let's turn the color overlays on. Let's give this a different color. Actually, let's put both the arms now. Let's put the arm warp into the completed masks and give both the completed mask and that other arm there the same color, which will be cyan. Turn off the other overlays there and let's play that forward. And that's not bad. I can see there's a few bits where it's drifting. I need to fill in just a couple of little areas. But I think that's looking pretty good. Like here, we can see that
probably just need to go on to some of the keyframes that I've already got and just make those a little bit tighter. But before we go, I'm also going to do the neck as well, because the neck is very similar to what we've got already. We don't really want to bother tracking it as a sort of moving neck, because we're just going to use it to fill in most of that area. So it doesn't really matter what the neck is moving or how the neck is moving. We just need to get the outline of it. So I'll turn the outlines back on and turn the overlays off. I can be a little bit rough and ready around a load of this place, because we're going to be covering most of it in hair, or hair is going to be covering most of it, I should say. I'll bring that up a little bit there. There we go. And we'll connect this one again to the background track. Neck mask. And we'll just be maneuvering this into place. And this just needs to start to fill in the gaps. This is really all this is doing. So it doesn't need to be 100% perfect. In fact, you know, we won't be, you know, I really don't want to waste too much time with doing it. It's just going to be a nice thing to have, so we don't have to worry about it later. So this movement here, as long as this movement isn't bringing in stuff that we don't want it to, which is a little bit in the background, I don't really worry too much about it. I will worry about point-to-point matching, though, because that is always something I worry about. There we go. Much nicer. Then bring it to the next major area. Just distort that in. Am I going to worry too much about getting it more accurate than that? Nope. How about here? Again, just distort that in a little bit so we're in roughly the right place. It's mainly just filling in. There we go. The important parts are where it starts to separate out from other areas, and I think it's absolutely fine there. Cool. All right. So with the neck mask done, I will do the final little tweaks to the arm mask off camera, just to, you know, do the little few pixel changes that I need to do. So in this part of the exercise, we've been looking at creating shapes where we can't get good tracking data on it. So this being an extension of what we've done in the previous exercise, but it's taking it a little bit further. I've shown you the importance of point-to-point matching and how we can start to infer where shapes are and where shapes should go to using the surrounding control points and how important that's going to be. Okay, in the next part, we are going to be concentrating on the head, and specifically, we're going to be looking first at the sunglasses and the problems and opportunities, actually, that those are going to present to us. So join me in part 4 of exercise 10, the basics of a Roto. Continued. See you in a minute.
You've been watching the free version of Mocha Essentials. To download all videos, projects, and footage, purchase the premium version, available at BorisFX.com.